or if it's a good amount of money that you're making, you know, just by flipping it, you know, right away, then just sell it, get rid of it.
How did you learn so much about this industry? Because most fighters, in general, most athletes, not only fighters, they focus on their sport. And then when they're retired, they have to start from zero to learn about anything. Because
I bought my first house 7 years ago. And when Rai was born.
Were you pro yet?
Yeah. I've been pro since 18.
Well, Frank says you've been pro since he was 12.
I was here in Moreno Valley when I bought the first house. And it was cool because, like, it was my first house. I was all excited, you know. And I stayed under my budget so that I wouldn't risk, you know, in case. I was in champion yet, right? So I was like, well, in case boxing doesn't do it for me, I can still afford this house without any problems. So I did. I bought the house, and I was all excited, you know, for my first home. But you start learning the process. You start learning. And then a year later, I bought my first rental property. And I bought two. And then a year and after that, I bought another one. And so I just started to learn more and more. Then when I stopped fighting, that year is when I bought the house where I'm living at right now. You went right now. I bought that one. And then I stopped fighting. Is that
right?
And so I started focusing on rentals and flips while I was out of boxing. I'm not fighting, so I stay busy doing.
And then you got the 11-acre ranch.
That's when I started learning a lot more. Because you got more involved. The more you do it, the more you learn. And then right before I came back 2 years ago is when I bought the ranch. I just saw an opportunity to come up on a great property. Derecho, okay, wait.
Yeah, derecho. So Longhorn a la derecha.
Longhorn has like Texas.
So
you haven't wasted really any opportunity, not just relying on your athleticism or on the money you can make from sponsors or TV network.
The money that comes from boxing is obviously a lot greater, and
I mean, it's
where I make my money from. But there's nothing wrong with making, you know, extra cash with that same money. You know, so if you have, say, $300,000 just sitting in the bank, before you know it, you're down to $200,000. And before you know it, you're at $100,000. And you're like, what the fuck did I just do with this money? You know? I mean, I'm not gonna.
We're going to just try to,
do that. So, those $300,000, buy a property for, you know, $250,000, $260,000, whatever. Put another $20,000, $30,000, you know. So, with $300,000, you invest in a property and you end up selling the property for close to $400,000.
Who can make $100,000 in 6 months?
So you're making $60,000, $80,000 in 4 or 5 months or less.
That's what people do make in a year.
So why not do that, you know?
Paulie Malignaggi told me once.
If you can make $50,000 in 3 months, with that same money that would have already been, that you probably would have spent $50,000, you know?
You know what Paulie tells me?
Yeah.
He puts his money in real estate.
Yeah.
Where are we, Mikey? Where are we going?
Shit, I'm fucking under a bigger.
Yeah, you want to dive in here.
I guess I should have brought my gun.
Yeah.
Where
are we
going?
We're going
to
get jumped.
We're fucking getting jacked over here. I brought my gun.
Oh, no. Lo vinimos a los gallos.
Hey. Oh, ese acá.
Good thing you brought your truck.
Yeah.
No, Paulie told me he likes to have his money tied up in real estate so he doesn't waste it. Because when it's tied up in real estate, you cannot touch it.
You can't touch it.
And I think other superstars do the same, other boxers.
It's not liquid cash that you can just touch.
No. So you make money and you make sure you can't waste it.
Yeah, it's good.
What's the most you ever made on a flip?
About
$100,000.
Straight. So about. Actually, ¿cuánto costó la célula de Perry, el ranchito de Perry? ¿Cuánto le metimos ahí?
Unos
30
por ahí.
¿Cómo 30, ah? So, on that one, making about 85.
That's amazing.
And I could have made a little more if I kept some of the costs down.
Yeah.
But I wanted to really show it so it could be a
like nicer. The bathroom with the, what's it called? The tile.
Okay.
We got
granite countertops, bro. You know, brand new kitchen cabinets. You know,
brand new those showers.
Plastic.
And, you know, brand new showers. You know, we put cement all around. You know, nice cement.
That costs
a
lot of money,
so,
too.
Exactly. So we did. We did more than what's needed.
Got it.
But I wanted to do that so we can actually show it off.
So you can move it faster,
and
too.
And so it can, you know, be more presentable. So it gets more attention, more attraction. And also, because that one was going to be for Jonathan.
What?
He didn't get it. Oh. He ended up getting something else. But quite. But that one was only for Jonathan.
So you invested more in it. That's nice of you.
Yeah, but that's all right. I'm getting my money back, you know.
No, you are, of course. Oh, well. Plus, Mike, in the end of the day.
Yeah, we made it. Okay, two.
What's the white car, the Land Rover?
Yeah.
You could have brought that one here, too.
Yeah, but I'm saying being good in real estate or this knowledge you have will help you your entire life. Are these even roads or is this like...
Actually, Nelly, that guy, he bought Mike right now to the ranch.
Yeah.
He wanted to sell his ranch.
To Mike? This ranch, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
What's he selling it for?
Well, over like million.
Is that a good deal?
I don't know.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.